Hi all. In this video we are going to see energy conservation and refrigeration and air conditioning system. That is, both are working under the same principle. That is, that both are used to cool or heat a particular purposeful environment. That is, here we are going to see energy performance assessment in HVAC system. That is, heating, ventilation, air conditioning system. Commonly in the air conditioners, nowadays air conditioner refrigerations are commonly used in any buildings or in process industries like IT fields, that is software fields, software industries and other hospitals and partially in houses, that is residential areas. They are using AC for a cooling purpose, for a specific area cooling purpose, that is for a single room cooling, to create a single room cooling environment in a house or any residential areas. These are the main purpose of the AC or refrigeration, to cool or in order to preserve some foods in under some cooling temperature. They are using refrigerators. The energy consumed in that is AC and refrigeration system is sensitive to load changes and seasonal variations, and they can operation and maintenance and have the ambient conditions, etc. That is, these are the main factors in the energy consumed, that is energy consumption in air conditioning and refrigeration system. Hence, the performance evolution will have account to extent possible all of these mentioned factors, that is the above factors. The main purpose of the performance test, that is the performance test, is to verify the performance of the refrigeration system by using field measurements and other test conditions, that is to net cooling capacity, that is tons of refrigeration. It is one of the terms we will see in upcoming topics, that is what are the terms relating to refrigeration, and at the actual operating condition. The objective of the test is to estimate the energy consumption at a low, that is at actual load design conditions. This is the major objective of the test. Next we will see the performance terms and definitions, that is tons of refrigeration. 1 ton of refrigeration is the amount of cooling obtained by 1 ton of ice melting in 1 day, that is which is equivalent to 3024 kilocalories per hour, 12,000 BTU per hour, or 3.516 thermal kilowatt. This is the tons of refrigeration. Next is net refrigerating capacity, that is a quantity defined, that is, it is a quantity that defines the mass flow rate of the evaporator water multiplied by the difference in enthalpy of water entering and leaving the cooler, which is expressed as represented by kilocalories per hour tons of refrigeration. Next term is kilowatt per ton rating, that is they are commonly referred to the efficiency, that is power input to compressor motor divided by tons of cooling produced, or kilowatts per ton. That is a lower kilowatt per ton indicates higher efficiency. Next is a coefficient of performance, that is the performance of the cooling system. Chiller efficiency measured in VTU output divided by VTU input, that is electric power. This is the cooling, that is the output of the cooling system divided by the input, that is power, electric power, input electric power. Next is EER, that is energy efficiency ratio. Which is given by performance of smaller chillers and rooftop units is frequently measured in EER rather than kilowatt per ton. They are calculated by dividing the chiller's cooling capacity in BTU per hour by its power input at full load condition, that is the maximum load or full load condition, the values to be taken, and the higher the ERP, that is EER, the more efficient the unit, that is more the, if the value of ER, that is energy efficient ratio, is high, then motor efficient, that is more efficient, will have the will be the unit. Next is preparatory for measurements, that is what are the preparatory measurements, that is to minimize the effect of transient conditions. Test readings should be taken as nearly simultaneously, that is the test readings, that is in the this comes under monitoring monitoring condition, that is we have to monitor the transient condition, that is various changing conditions, and we have to note down the various readings related to the surrounding temperature or surrounding observations, that is surrounding condition. The procedure, that is to determine the net refrigeration capacity, what we have to do, that is we have to determine the following factor, that is water flow rate, temperature difference between entering and leaving water. Here the net refrigeration capacity in tons shall be obtained by the following formula, that is net refrigeration capacity TR is equivalent to the relation, that is relation combination of relations like mass flow rate of chilled water into specific heat into T in minus T out, that is chilled water temperature at evaporator inlet degree Celsius divided by chilled water temperature at evaporator outlet degree Celsius divided by 3224, that is a constant value from the manufacturing side, and it is the accurate temperature measurement is very vital in refrigeration and air conditioning, and least count should be at least one decimal. The next one is methods of measuring the flow, that is in the absence of an online flow meter, the chilled water flow can be measured by the following methods, that is in case where hot well and cold well are available, the flow can be measured from the tank level tip or rise by switching of the secondary pump. The next one is non-invasive method, and the third one is if the water side pressure drops are close to the design values, it can be assumed that the water flow of pump is same as the design rated flow. Next is the measurement of compressor power, that is how the compressor power can be measured. It can be measured by using the portable power analyzer, which would give the direct reading of the compressor power in kilowatt, that is which is given by root 3 into voltage into current into power factor. Here the power factor is assumed as 0.9. Next is performance calculations, that is the energy efficiency of a chiller is commonly expressed in one of the three following ratios, that is the first ratio is coefficient of performance COP, that is kilowatt refrigeration effect divided by kilowatt input, and the second one is energy efficiency ratio, which is given by the ratio of BTU per hour refrigeration effect to the watt input. Power per ton, kilowatt per ton is the ratio between kilowatt input to the tons refrigeration effect. First we have to calculate the kilowatt per ton, that is power per ton from the measured parameters, that is measured compressor power in kilowatt divided by net refrigeration capacity, that is tons of refrigeration. Using these data to calculate other energy efficiency parameters, the following relations, that is COP, next is power per ton, next is EER, that is energy efficiency refrigeration ratio, next is COP, coefficient of performance, these are the factors. Using this data, we have to calculate COP and energy efficiency ratio. The performance evaluation of air conditioning system, that is for a centralized air conditioning system, the air flow at the air handling unit can be measured with the anemometer, which is to measure the speed of the wind, that is bin speed and the dry bulb and wet bulb temperatures can be measured at the AHU, that is air handling unit, inlet and outlet. The data can be used along with the psychometric chart, that is psychometric chart is shown here, that is to determine the enthalpy content, that is the heat content of air at the AHU, inlet and outlet. Here it has been given a relation between the TR into TRC with the mass flow rate and enthalpy of inlet air and enthalpy of outlet air. And next we have to find the measurement, that is we have to know about the measurements to be recorded during the test, that is evaporator and compressor. Or in the evaporator, the temperature of water entering evaporator and the temperature of water leaving the evaporator and the chilled water flow rates and other evaporator water pressure drop. And next is in compressor, power input to compressor, electric power kilowatt. These are the parameters to be recorded during the test. And here we have some saving here in the session, in this session. I have referred some journals, that is articles related to energy conservation in air conditioning and refrigeration system. Before entering into this, we will see what is a refrigeration system and HVAC. That is, refrigeration is nothing but which deals with the transfer of heat from a low temperature level at the heat source to the high temperature level at the heat sink, that is heat sink by using the low boiling refrigerant. This is the common heat transfer loops in any refrigeration system, that is supplying a air fan, and chilled water pump. And the next is the evaporator, compressor, here the refrigerant and the condenser and the condenser pump. Next is cooling tower. Once again the process repeats, that is cooling tower fan and the process repeats. This is the common loop available in a refrigeration system. And here there are space and expelled into the outdoors through the five loops of heat transfer, that is indoor air loop, chilled water loop, condenser water loop and cooling water loop. These are major five loops, that is another one is these are the major five loops of heat transfer in a refrigerant system. And air conditioning system, that is air conditioning, split air conditioners, fan coil units in a large system, air handling units in a larger system are basically the dependent application for several areas, that is several options and several combinations will have such these type of systems, that is air conditioning system. And refrigeration system for the purpose, that is small capacity modular unit of direct expansion type, similar to domestic refrigerators, and they have other properties. If you want, you can pause the video and just read it. It is a simple properties, this is not related to this session, but we just know that is what are the refrigeration system is available and what are the types are available in the refrigeration system, so that I am showing this material, that is which is taken from Bureau of Energy Efficiency, which is accurate and a tested material or a tested result with material contains 100% accurate results. That is here there are different types of refrigeration system, that is vapor compression refrigeration. And here we have alternative the vapor compression system. Next is absorption refrigeration. Here you can see the process flow and how the cooling process has been done using evaporator and condenser. You just pause the video and see or read it. Here we have what are the solutions they have used. They just mentioned here, that is a lithium bromide solution, they have is diluted and is in diluted form. They are using it as a refrigerant for cooling purpose. next is how the condenser and evaporator and absorber they are working, how the process is happening with the refrigerants, two stage steam fired absorption unit, here they are shown, the evaporative cooling and the common refrigerants and properties are available. Here there are some commonly used refrigerants, properties of such commonly used refrigerants are available. These are the standard, that is the real-time tested parameters, that is parameter with proof they have taken this reading as per Bureau of Energy Efficiency. Next is we have seen compressor types and application. These we have seen in the previous videos in our channel. Centrifugal compressors, reciprocating compressors and other things, vane compressors. We have seen animation effect. This for these type of compressors. If you see these parameters, you can analyze what is what. And a selection of suitable refrigeration system, and we have seen a performance assessment in the previous material. Next we will see how the energy saving is happening in air conditioning and refrigeration system, that is orientation of building, that is since the heat from the sun is major source of load, that is if we consider any cooling system or if you create any cooling system, the major factor, the major thing we have to consider is heat, that is heat from the surrounding to the consider our purposeful cooling system, that is heat from the sun is the major source of load, and the directional orientation of building can affect the significantly on the heat load. As India, that is when we consider India as one of the area where the cooling system is installing, means as India lies between the equator and the Tropic of Cancer, hence the heat from the sun enters in the building essentially from eastern and western direction. By 4 p.m. heat load within building reaches its peak, hence the afternoon sun seems to be greater than the morning. By keeping the directional factor in mind so as to keep the effect of effect of western heat to the minimum. This is the orientation of a building in India, that is when we consider India as a India. Next is use of glazing glass for door and windows, that is particularly they will use, instead of brick wall they are using glass, that is instead of using windows they are using normal windows, that is wooden windows, they are using glazing glass for doors and windows not to avoid a glass wall unless absolutely necessary. However, if glass is must, minimize the double glazing, that is double glass with the air insulation in between, and using tinted glass, that is tinted glass is one kind of glass to have a higher that is to reduce the not to reduce the heat from the outdoor environment to the indoor environment, reduce the entry of heat, and providing Venetian blinds. Next is using sun films or glass, or a sun film certainly reduces the heat energy through the glass, which is around 70% accurate, performs 70% performance is 70% good. Next is heat from roof, that is if the roof is exposed to sun, a direct heat inflow into the space is tremendous. This is a major factor we have to consider. And another is heat from electric appliances, that is like fans and lightings and any for example induction stoves, these things, these electrical or electronic appliances will eject heats, more heats. So these here in the conditioning system, that is the air condition must also cool such type of electrical apparatus, that is electrical appliances, so that the environment must be in under cooling condition. That is one of the most considerable point. The another one is electronic controls are more reliable and long lasting than conventional knob and switches and also more accurate and efficient. Electronic thermometer are precise, hence for cut out and cut in of compressor occurs precisely in precisely to save the energy. This is one of the considerable point. Next is in this paper here they have mentioned an energy audit of a central air conditioning plant of BSNL administrative building. That is, they have considered building of a BSNL administrative. They have monitored and collected data to not to improve the energy efficiency. That is, energy saving technique in AC and refrigeration. That is, data collection of existing system, which is more detailed and informative. That is, water cooled chiller and other parameters like condenser pump, chilled water primary pump and other secondary pump, performance values are tested values, and inspection and study of individual equipment for their working and performance. That is, a physical inspection of each component and recording the observation from various metering devices. Next is checking and verifying the history sheets maintained for their recording, working schedule of plant and other parameters are recorded and monitored or collected. Next is the observations. During this project, it is found that the individual component is working satisfactorily. That is, almost for 1 and a half year, the system is working on its partial load, that is between 40% to 60%. VFT for secondary chilled water system is provided to reduce the or increase the power consumption on various load, that is as per variations of load. These are the parameters, that is potential for energy saving, another thing. To be considered in this BSNL administrative building. And finally, they have in this paper they have mentioned for efficient any cooling condition or air conditioning, we need to minimize the entry of heat from the sun in the conditioned space by planting trees around the building and providing sunshades. Next is wingings, etc. Windows and doors, zero windows and doors. And next is using a sun film, curtains or Venetian blinds and other things. This is the most important point that I already discussed. Next is insulating exposed roofs. The other one is to prevent leakage of cooled air to the outside. That is, the cooled inside in the place where we are doing cooling operation. The cooling, there should not be any leakage to the surrounding, or if there is any leakage or any path to and communicate with the outer environment, there will be no use of a cooling system and it won't work efficiently. All corners and edges around joinery, that is doors and windows, must be airtight. And next is close the windows and doors perfectly. Next is doors and windows are not unnecessarily and too often opened and closed. That is, for alternative opening and closing of the windows or doors will eventually or accordingly causes loss of energy, that is energy, cooling energy. The heat energy will also affect the environment of the cooling system. Thus the system, the cooling, the air conditioning machine or air conditioning system will get affected due to these factors. So we have to consider these factors in order to improve the or saving the energy in any cooling system or AC or refrigeration system. Thus, this is about energy conservation and refrigeration system and air conditioning system. If any comments or suggestion is available, or if any queries related to this topic, kindly comment or mention in the comment box. If anyone is not subscribed to the channel, kindly subscribe to the channel for more topics related to engineering and gamings and next bike related and the new updates. Thank you and subscribe to the channel.